Contracting the coronavirus can lead to social stigma. Symptom can persist for weeks to months. For many people living through this, sharing their story is the only way validated. Here's what some of the survivors have to say and what you need to know. Dr. Samri Amoki is a medical doctor turned trade unionist of over 20 years. The former workers MP spent weeks battling COVID-19 at Mulago National Referral Hospital, and now he gives his ordeal. He says that initially he thought he had malaria and started treatment, but the pain persisted.
In the beginning, I started treating as malaria because I didn't expect COVID really, because I had done all the scopes. But later on, when they recognized, I didn't have doubt because I didn't realize at all these actual signs. And actually, I'd been falling sick of malaria, and also some few times I'd been admitted, but this is the first time I had the type of pain I was feeling. The body was so bad. To the extent that at one time I got disgusted with the body because they are giving me painkillers, but the pain is not going. The fever is so much, like the body is burning, not the fever I always get. Because the malaria fever, you know, chills and slow. But it's a fever which is like the body is burning. And then I realized that, again, if I fry the body, I would die because you can't live in this house without a body.
So Neriamoki narrates that as he was struggling for his life in the high dependence unit, one question kept on lingering in his mind.
The question, what happens when you die? You know, that is a question. Every time you think of such a question, you know, try to dodge because you know that my death is far. It's always that depression. But now here I am, and there are 50-50 chances either of recovering or of continuing. And I said, okay, if I die today, what happens? So now I was in that one, asking God to take over, and whatever happens, I handed everything to him. Then I realized that question is very simple if you are in the Lord.
Dr. Amoki says that his experience at the hospital brought him closer to God and has changed his life and the way he looks at things.
For a vessel, I'm just thanking God, trying to sing, oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider, oh, the works thy hands have made. God, that now by the time I reached and almost crossed, but finally gave me a chance to continue living, I knew that the time I'm going to live, I should use it productively to conclude.
In the isolation room, he says that he felt so lonely, abandoned, and driven into panic mood.
You know, you go to hospital with your family, because usually you go together. And then, when they discover that you have COVID, you are separated. Now, then it starts. So that shows it gives a very big, big loneliness because, okay, like for my, I'm separate now, I'm with the health workers, but the health workers are in PPE. And then that separation from the family gives you another very big haunting, because you see, you start seeing, oh, it even makes you think that you are now, the death is near, because you, and then I say now, you remember, colleagues who are fallen sick, you go there and bad, and you come back, all of you, and leave them. So that's the thing now. Oh, so it's like, I will never see this again. So it's like now, from here, you're just going to be taken to bed. So,
the COVID-19 survivor has no kind words for private hospitals that are charging exorbitant monies to manage COVID-19, but thank the management of Mulago Hospital.
That private sector charging 3 million. For me, I'm sorry, they are my colleagues, but that's being acting as scavengers, because I don't think that the treatment, because I know the type of drugs we give, okay, even oxygen, it cannot be worth the 3 million to people, really. That's too much per day. And I think the government should do prevail over this, the private units. I know they can, it's difficult to establish IC, whatever, but you know, instead of scavenging over people I need, because people here are so desperate. Actually, in the private unit, I was supposed to pay 3 million per day. But here, when I look at this thing, if you compare the standard, this was almost, if not the private, I would even pay 20 million per day. So I come out of that place, and I'm not paying any money. Free. So it's like I saved over 100 million.
He appealed to the general public to strictly observe the standard operating procedures to avoid hospitalization, and to all those doubting that COVID-19 is not there, take him as an example.
You are in that pain and experience as a human being, you don't want anyone, even if you have someone, maybe is here anymore, you don't want that person to go there, because it's a tough thing.
So you're trying to that no one should go there. Let people just prevent themselves. Because I got COVID, tested, proved, I've been treated, and I've come out. So for me, that type of speculation should not really arise. People should know that for sure it's COVID.
COVID-19 can affect the lungs and the body's immune system and can lead to stroke and psychosis.
By this broadcast, let people know that COVID is not, should not be feared, but we should take our stand as children of Azure children and believe in your healing.
Zahra Abigawa, UBC.